Hey guys, in this new video, we're gonna finally take a look at the strength of bases. So, up to this point, we've talked about acids. We've talked about binary acids and oxy acids. And we should know their strengths at this point as well. How do we determine when they're weak and when they're strong? Again, this is important because weak acids, we have to use an ice chart in order to find pH. Strong acids, we don't have to do that. So what we're gonna say now is, let's take a look at bases. We're going to say strong bases are considered to be strong electrolytes. And what does strong electrolytes mean? It means that it completely breaks up or dissociates when dissolved in water. Here you're going to notice that we have a solid arrow going forward. Again, this means reaction goes to completion. So all of the reactant will break down basically to 100%, so we get those two ions. We get Na plus, OH minus. Now, weak acids are considered to be weak electrolytes. So they don't completely break down, they don't completely ionize. Here again, we'll notice that there's a double arrow, meaning that an equilibrium is established. That means our reaction goes in the forward direction as well as the reverse direction. Now, weak acids, weak bases, favor the reactants. All that means is that our reactants really don't break down that much. So a majority of our compound will be in the form of reactant. Very little of it will be made into product. In the opposite way, strong acids and strong bases favor, we're going to say they favor the products, which means nearly all of our reactant breaks down to give us products. So again, remember, weak acids, weak bases, we need to use an ice chart to find pH or POH. We'll talk about those later down the road. It's imperative that you guys remember how to identify things.